Calderon. Welcome back to my channel. As a former teacher's paid teacher seller, well, technically I still get that passive income, and teacher Instagrammer that now leads social media and influencer marketing for two edtech brands, it comes as no surprise that I absolutely love all things social media and content marketing strategy. And that's why Teacher Marketing Academy has been formed. Yes, I am still in the early beta phases, but on my Instagram, I launched that soon I will be starting a Teacher Marketing Academy that will have tons of resources for you. Coaching, consulting, all the great things. I have an interest form. I'm gonna link it down below. These videos are still going to exist, but only those that are on my email list are going to get tips and firsthand social media knowledge that I get being in the field for a living first. So you wanna make sure you click both of those links down below. And I am so pumped for this, y'all. It just gives me so much joy. And that's why I am excited. How many times have I said excited? A little bit, right? A little bit. That's why I'm touching my hair and doing all these crazy things. But get ready, people. It's coming. This video is all about how you can make money from your teacher blog or website. So let me tell you a secret. A teacher blog is not outdated. It's the main reason why I was still able to bring in passive income to my Teachers Pay Teachers store, because I had strong foundations ahead of time. You can still use it as a way to drive revenue to the sources or make revenue on that blog itself. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, because this lets me know you want to see more content like this. And if you want more tips or want me to dive deeper into these videos, leave me a comment below, send me an email, amber@teachermarketingacademy.com, because I would love to create content that you're most interested in, but I only know if you tell me. Okay, let's talk about how to make money from your teacher blog. And the first one, I am kicking myself that I did not do this when I was a teacher that was heavily blogging in the classroom, because all of the money that I could have received. And it's Google AdSense. So Google AdSense, all you need to do is create an account with Google AdSense, connect it to your website, and it's minimal effort on your end. It's gonna put display advertisements across your website, and then you will get money based on users that go to your website and click those advertisements. I will say I have heard some teacher bloggers not want to use Google AdSense because they feel like it messes up their overall aesthetic on their website, and I feel that. However, in Google AdSense, you can set exclusions to remove ads from certain parts of your site. So if you go to my website and you look around, you'll notice on my main page, you will not see any advertisements, but you will see display advertisements on the sidebar and when you actually go into the contents of the blog. Also, if there are certain blogs that you just don't want them there, you can set that as an exclusion as well. So you can be really flexible with that. In December of 2020, I made $215.67 doing absolutely nothing. I just set it up. I didn't do anything. I wasn't even blogging consistently. And that's the amount of revenue that I brought in that month. Now, to someone who may have been doing this for a while, that may not seem like a lot of money. I don't care if I made $5 or $10. That's money that I wouldn't have had, and it didn't require any effort. So, also know that as you're just starting out, you are not gonna probably bring in as much revenue right off the bat, but it is something in there for the long haul that you can bring in and keep as passive income. Another way to bring money to your teacher blog is going to be for those who are selling on Teachers Pay Teachers or those that have digital products. You can social sell about topics of products that you've written about on Teachers Pay Teachers. One of the ways that you can social sell is think about a problem your audience has and try to find a way to solve it and pivot your resource in a way that solves that problem. For example, I wrote this blog post about teaching time and elapsed time, and I'm very proud of the pictures. It's already enticing in the way that I'm marketing it. When you click it, I am teaching you strategies to teach your students how to teach elapsed time. I'm showing how I do it. I'm explaining the problem of what students may struggle with, giving teachers guidance on how to remedy that. I also throw in a freebie so then they see the quality of my work. And then by the time they get through the end of the blog post, boom, I've actually made this a step easier for you by creating these resources for you. Click here and purchase. And I make money off of this product because of this blog post. The same is true with all of my classroom management blog posts that I wrote. I noticed I was making tons of money off of it, and so I created a series into these blog posts, and now it's my second highest selling product on Teachers Pay Teachers, and I attribute it to these blog posts that showed me my audience was interested. I looked in my Google Analytics, which we can talk about later, and I created blog posts to sell that product. Solving a problem is just one way that you can write blog posts. There are so many other scripts that you can use. I will have scripts coming soon, so keep an eye out for that. I've got so many things cooking for Teacher Marketing Academy. We've talked about Google AdSense, we've talked about social selling through Teachers Pay Teachers, and now we're going to talk about affiliate marketing. So affiliate marketing is going to be an easy way that you can drive passive income to your site. I am an Amazon influencer, which means I have a storefront that has all of my favorite products that I would use, buy, purchase anyways. I just have it in a display, so then if people have questions about any of my products, I drive them there. I recently received this Instagram just yesterday. I wasn't even promoting the laptop case. I was just talking about it, and a kind teacher liked it and asked to use my link, which I thought was amazing. So I recommend applying for an Amazon influencer account so you can get started that way. Also, now you're probably thinking, but how am I gonna make money off of this? Think of the products that you're already purchasing, because then you can take real life pictures of these products, right? How can you create a roundup post? My 5 math virtual teaching must-haves in the classroom, and now it's a roundup post that you have the pictures, you have the links to your products, linking to your store. Now you have this piece of content that you can share everywhere and you can make money off of it. Also, I wrote a blog post in the very beginning of my blogging about these write-on wipe-off boards because I just thought they were so great. I really didn't know what I was doing when I was linking to them. I still make money off of this blog post as an affiliate for these products. So it just goes to show you, when you create that evergreen content, look around your classroom the next time you walk in. Look at your house the next time you walk in. What could you collect into a blog post so then you can market it to your audience in an authentic way? When you are just starting out, it's hard for people to just fall in love with you if you're not teaching them something, okay? The same is true for the blog post. For example, if you look at my YouTube channel, my vlogs don't really do that great because you don't really know who I am. You haven't grown to get to know me. We don't really know each other yet, right? So for you to see those vlog videos that are an intimate part of my life, it's just not quite there. But guess what? I know that, but I'm still creating this content because we'll get there. We'll be friends. But notice, I'm also creating teaching content. So when you look at my videos specifically about Nearpod, I have one YouTube video with 19,000 views. It's my highest view because I'm teaching you something. The same is true with your blog. When you are social selling, you're teaching them something and then you're getting them to convert, okay? Now, the same is with your affiliates. People may like that stuff, but if you're a newer seller, why are they gonna go to that site? What can you teach them? If you're a science teacher and you have these resources that you purchase for a virtual science lab, you can teach another science teacher how to do that by linking everything and then teaching them that lesson. So just keep that in mind if you're not as established yet and you're still trying to make people fall in love with you. Trust me, they will through your amazing personality. Make sure you're also teaching them something and using your affiliates to drive that as well. The next form of affiliate marketing that, again, I am kicking myself that I did not do this. I actually got approved right before my camping trip, and then I didn't do anything with it because I was like, I can't do this right now. And it is Like to Know It. I applied to be a Like to Know It influencer, and let me just go ahead and say that in the past 7 days, I've made over $70 just sharing resources of clothes that I've already would have purchased anyways, but because my audience is now growing to trust me, maybe they like my style. I mean, I don't really have a lot of clothes, so I'm kind of sharing the same thing over and over again, to be honest. If you've watched my other videos, you know I'm sharing my clothes on Poshmark. Make me an offer, I'm just trying to get rid of them. That is another way you can earn money, by the way. Like to Know It is going to be a way that you can share sales, pictures, classroom pictures. Basically, it's Instagram with a more shoppable feed, and you earn a commission off of what you sell. So I showed you the stats of what I make. If it's something that you're interested in, if you're thinking your audience would enjoy that, I recommend applying. I'm sharing this with you because I am also on this journey with you as well. So it would be silly if I pretended like I was way up here. I took a 4-year hiatus. I stopped posting across all my channels, but it was because of the strong foundations that I built before I stepped out of a classroom that I'm still able to generate that passive income, and there's still somewhat of a brand presence between me and my audience. So just know that I am also practicing what I'm preaching, and that's why I used my strategies but took it too Like to Know It last week, and I made $70. So yes, again, that's not a crazy amount of money, but it's whenever we get into that mindset of like, oh, I didn't make $500, that we then become discouraged and then want to stop. But I'm going to keep moving along, I'm going to keep trucking along, and I hope you'll do the same with me. The next way that you can earn money on your teacher blog is going to be for those that are maybe a little more established, but if you're not there yet, you're going to aspire to be, so you want to keep listening, and that's going to be sponsored content. If you're looking for sponsored content, I recommend making sure that you have a consistent blogging calendar. In the influencer marketing world, as you know, I lead social media and influencer marketing for those two ed tech brands. And when I'm looking for a teacher to work with and pay them for content, if I see that their last blog post was a year ago or even 6 months ago, then I know their blog post is stagnant and it's probably not driving traffic that it should. So I'm less likely to want to work with them in that avenue. But if you're taking your other content and putting it on your blog, which we'll talk about in point two, looking for what to write, making sure that you keep a consistent blogging calendar just so then you have additional streams of income for that sponsored content. And now you can package up an Instagram post, an Instagram story, and pair it with blog content. And that's gonna maximize your total revenue earned from that brand. But if you're only on one channel, now your limitation is just this channel. Now it could be a great number, but we always want to aspire for more, right? If this is something you might be ready for, I highly recommend having a media kit. Again, as somebody that was on the teacher side that is now on the influencer marketing side for businesses, it makes my heart sing when I reach out to an influencer and they already have a media kit. I know what I need to pay them. I know what their packages are. Oh, the influencers that have the packages that I can see, oh, I could get this, this, and this. There's an a la carte, but then there's a bundle with a discount. That to me shows that they're thinking in a strategic sales mindset. And then also take it a step further to the ones that are open to collaboration for ideas. That makes me think, they're probably really flexible to work with. And when I see something like that, I think to myself, if they're this organized, then working with them through the approval process and the content creation and the invoicing is going to be amazing. So something to keep in mind, how you handle yourself with businesses is going to help that longer term partnership, so then it's not a one-off payment. If sponsored content is something that you're looking for, I highly recommend getting a knowledge base with Google Analytics, because being able to share those analytics with the brand is only going to raise your number higher. A teacher can have a beautiful website, and when I go to it, it looks gorgeous. But if you're only driving X amount of unique users to your site, it's not really worth any value for that brand. But if you know and can share that data with that brand, now you can advocate for you and your worth and get the number that you deserve as an influencer, which is so important. So if you don't have an understanding with Google Analytics, if that's something that you want to learn and get a Google Analytics 101 with me, I'm happy to create content on that, but you just got to let me know. The last way to earn money on your blog is a little unconventional, but hear me out. as someone who lives and breathes social media, and I firmly believe social media is where we are in the world. But what if Instagram comes back tomorrow and says, you know what, you violated something, and you didn't even violate it, and they took your account away. And then Facebook all of a sudden deactivated your account. How are you gonna reach your followers? How are you gonna still make money? How long is it gonna take you to get that prior income if you are starting from scratch? So I recommend building your email list now. Even if you're not ready for email marketing or sending out campaigns yet, I recommend building a list because then you own those emails and nobody can take that away from you, which is exactly what I'm doing in this video. So if you're interested in teacher marketing tips that are more detailed than what you're seeing from these surface level videos, please fill out the interest forms. I'm leaving the link in the description box because I would love for you to join my email list because I am getting firsthand knowledge of all of these strategies and all of these trends that are happening before, because it's my job to always know what's going on. And you are always teaching. You're always teaching. You don't have the time to do that. You want to spend time with your family. Hello, we need to sleep. So why don't I give you back that time by sending you a weekly tip, a monthly tip, whatever your email preferences are, but that way you can get back time and focus on building your business with the tools and strategies that I'm giving you to succeed. So if you're interested in that, please fill out the form below. I would love for you to join the Teacher Marketing Academy email list. And Teacher Marketing Academy is going to open. I cannot wait. Again, I have so many ideas. But you know what I say, we can do all things, but we can't do everything. So notice I told you you should build your email list. I'm also building my email list. It would be silly of me to talk about these things and not implement the strategies myself. So that's why I shared how much I made on Google Analytics. That's why I shared how much I made on Like to Know It, because I want to be transparent with you that as I'm running hard at my goals, I want you to run hard at your goals. But if I'm just telling somebody how to do something and I'm sitting on this throne eating my chicken or whatever and just pretending that like, yeah, do that, but I'm not doing it myself, how are you gonna trust me? So let's do this journey together. Let's reach our goals together. I'm pumped. Okay, these are all the different ways that you can earn money on your blog. There are more ways that you can do that, but I didn't want this video to get too long. And again, I didn't go into super detail with each point. You at least need the base level of everything. Thank you so much for watching this video all about how to make money on your teacher blog. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you never miss a video like this. If you're interested in other content or want me to dive deeper, leave me a comment down below. I would love to create more content, which is what you're interested in. And I know I've already said this, but if you are interested in getting strategic teacher marketing tips sent directly to your inbox, then you want to make sure you sign up for my email list because I will be doing just that. Thank you so much for watching. I am so motivated. I am all kinds of happy. I hope this video motivated you, and let's crush our goals together. Bye, guys.